Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of Let's Play Beyond Two Souls. In our last episode, we ended up finding out what happened to Jody after the tragic fire that pretty much almost ended the lives of not only hers, but our homeless family. And she ended up in a coma for at least 3 months because by the time she woke up from said coma, Tuesday had mentioned, well, you find out that it's been, Tuesday's baby is at least 3 months old. And there was like some flashbacks about her birth, and maybe we might have seen her mother, as well as some interesting stuff in the future that might be in store for us in the climax of this story, is my guess. And then we ended up flashing back to her childhood, her first night at the laboratory, which was so heartbreaking, and some of the issues that Jody had to work through during that time. And then we moved forward again to see Jody in a more rebellious stage of her life, which I think is going to be really neat to play with. One thing that I kind of wish that we learned a little bit more about what happened to her homeless companions, because I really love those characters a lot. Stan especially, as I've expressed how much I love Stan. I realized that the one character who brought the portrait, the photo of all four of the gang, four of the homeless gang, was Jimmy. I didn't catch that. I thought that was actually Stan, but it was actually Jimmy who was with the hat, with the cap, I think. But I didn't catch any objects in the hospital that told me about Walter. If any of you know whether or not there was an object I could have manipulated to get caught up with what was going on with Walter, let me know, because that was a person I felt was missing, once I realized that it was Jimmy who gave us the photo of the four of them. So anyway, let's go ahead and continue on with this rebellious chapter, I guess. We're gonna get up. I bet you we're gonna break out of here. I wouldn't be surprised if. Whoa, what's up there overhead? I wouldn't be surprised if she. Cole? No, I don't want to talk to Cole right now. Is there anything at the bar? I'll talk to Cole later. I want to see what. If there's anything here I can manipulate before I. Oh, there's her guitar! Oh, so she.
Go for it, Aiden.
Go for it, Aiden. Okay, is Aiden gonna help play? Okay. I didn't see her play that way at the homeless thing, but the homeless scene, but that's okay. Wow. Wow. She's really, really upset right now. Let it all out, girl. Oh, jeez. Jeez. Let's just take a look at her room. This is so different from 8-year-old Jody, or however old she was as a child. Oh, wait, where's Cuddles Bunny Gruff, or whatever her name was? Cuddles? They better not have gotten rid of her. Is that her in the shelf? No. Well, there's some of her. Oh, I recognize the. I was gonna say the chipmunk, but not Cuddles.
Go for it, Aiden.
Bunny Gruff. I'm assuming she's saying go for it, Aiden, because there's something that Aiden can do in here. Assuming. What does Aiden want to do? Aiden wants to break things. Aiden is frustrated as well. Oh gosh, I don't know if I want to break the television. Alright. Aiden's not very happy with the way that they're not letting her go out, so he's gonna go a little crazy.
Stop it, Jody! This is not gonna do you any good. You're grounded. Period.
It's not Jody, though.
Hey, Jody. You know better than to use Aiden when you're angry.
All right, fine. Let's see. Is there anything else I can do in here? She'd rather have... So, I can't break these things, so she wants Aiden to do her dirty work for her. I don't know if... I guess that would help make her feel better. Having someone else do it for her. I don't know. If I was really that angry and I wanted to break something, I would rather do it myself, not have somebody else do it for me. You know? I don't know. Come on, vent. Do whatever it is you need to do. Cry. This is really tough. Not being able to... Just being told that you're never going to fit in and you're never going to be able to live a normal life, which I don't... It's fine if that's true, but just one night, you can let her be normal and hopefully she's not going to burn the place down. I hope she won't. I mean, she didn't earlier when she was doing stuff at the party.
Enough! This is getting you nowhere.
Yeah, well, the game's not really giving me much of a choice now, so... I don't want to destroy the TV. That would shoot me more flammable.
Are you done?
Okay.
Are you proud of yourself? I hope so, because you have to clean all that up.
I do.
Stop it, Aiden. They don't give a shit if we break everything in this goddamn room. If that's not gonna work, we have to figure out what will.
All right. I can't switch back. Oh, there we go. Did my phone just ring?
Yeah. Yeah, she's calmed down. She smashed up the apartment first, but she's calmed down. Okay. Sure, I'll see you tomorrow.
Apparently we can't clean any of this up. Alright. We're not gonna clean any of this up. We are rebels. We are gonna not do what we're told and stuff. I'm so not the rebellious type. I really am not. I was, surprise, surprise, a huge goody-two-shoes as a kid. I did not have... I never went through the rebellious stage. I never did. I never had to. I was a relatively happy person in high school, relatively. Is there really nothing else for me to do but continue to destroy the apartment? Oh, I still can't call Cole. I can't contact Cole anymore. What's going on over there, that side, by the way? Oh, really? We are so gonna get in trouble. We are so gonna get in trouble, but I don't think the game's gonna give us another option, so... Have we done this before? Oh my gosh, all right. Hey.
Help me, Aiden. See if you find anything.
I'm just making sure that there's no other choice. If there's no other choice but to take control of Cole, then that's what we're gonna do. Because I don't think there's anything else. Ugh. It's okay. Eventually they're going to have to forgive us because soon after this we're going to rescue, we're going to save the world. So they'll have to forgive us at some point. Sorry, Cole. I didn't want it to have to come down to this, but you know, gotta do what the game tells us to do.
I'm really sorry, Cole. I hate myself for doing this, but you understand, right? I need to go out tonight.
Yeah, we can't touch Cole, because if we touch Cole, then we're in trouble. So I'm trying to steer away from him. I wonder what we're going to be doing tonight. Look at her. She looks awesome. You look awesome, girl. Especially with your purple Scottish kilt. Your purple kilt. Love that. It's actually a skirt, but it looks like a kilt from over here. Oh, man. Aren't there cameras, like, on the other side? Aren't there cameras around here, too?
Yeah, I know. It's too late to turn back now.
No, it's not. You can turn back now. Oh, that's just creepy. We're going to have Cole follow us. That is just really creepy. Ugh. Okay. Don't touch him, though.
Stupid. This is not the right way.
Well, I don't remember. I haven't been 6 years old in a while. I mean, at the beginning of this game. So, sue me. Sorry. ID card. Alright. Does Cole need to... Cole needs...
Locked.
Yeah.
Of course it is.
Cole needs to open the door for us. I can't switch over to Aiden right now to do it myself. So I'm just gonna have to not touch him. We're so gonna get in trouble. And I don't even give it back to him. I don't even put it back on his back. I'm not even trying to make this any better than it is. Well, whatever. He went right through us. I think Cole just turned into an entity himself. Oh. Wait, don't touch him. Don't touch him. Soda. Fresh. Drink. Okay. We have to get past the metal detectors. There's no surveillance cameras out here.
Well, hello, Cole. Jody. They're late for day trip, isn't it?
Cole was just taking me to see the shooting stars. Apparently there's like tons up there tonight. Have you seen them yet?
Listen, I don't know if Professor Dawkins would be all right with you going outside in the middle of the night.
Please. I mean, it's only going to be like a few minutes, and Cole is with me, and...
We're not saying anything. Just...
I've never seen a shooting star.
All right. Go ahead. I'll pretend I never saw you. What's up, Cole? Cat got your tongue? Hmm?
He lost his voice. I think it's like a virus or something. That's more than I've gotten out of him all day long.
Hope it's not contagious, buddy.
Don't touch him.
You should be home in bed if you ask me. Safer for all of us.
I was waiting for him to like...
All right, well,
pat him on the back or something. I can't believe that
actually... Go on now.
I can't believe that actually worked. Why are we taking Cole with us? Is it because we don't want him to remember what happened?
Well, at least we don't have to look for Cole's car.
So essentially we're...
There's cameras everywhere. Better not hang around here too long.
So essentially we're going out on a night on a town with our zombie scientist babysitter. And he's going to be driving us there? Can Aiden really do that? Oh, we're gonna drive. Do we have the keys? No, we don't. We're taking the poor man's car. I feel so bad for Cole. I really feel so bad.
Now get in the car and start it up.
Okay. I don't know if I would feel safe. Oh, jeez. Allowing Aiden to drive us to wherever it is we're... This is such a bad idea. We're going to the back seat. If we get Cole killed...
Damn. I'm not really out of sight.
This is what I'm worried about is... Like, we're putting Cole's life in danger right now. He's not in control of the car. He's at the mercy of Aiden knowing how to drive this thing. I don't think this will be any better. Can't you just lie down? I mean, it's not going to be any better up front. I'm not going into the trunk. Wait, is there a trunk option? Oh, no, I didn't want to go... Controls. I was just trying to manipulate the camera, but I couldn't. I don't think there's a way for us to. Oh. Seriously? So I can't... Let me get this straight. We're going to ride in the trunk so that even Jody can't see the road. So that Jody can't control Aiden to not hit anything. Here's the thing, I know that Jody would be less... I'm perfectly aware that Jody's goal is to not be seen, and if she does not want to be seen, she would jump into the trunk. I'm aware of that if that's her goal. However, I would like to believe at the same time, she also doesn't want to accidentally get into an accident, especially with Cole in the driver's seat. Especially since Cole is driving, he's basically being kidnapped and is being forced to drive this car under the mercy of an entity and making sure that the entity knows how to drive. No. Like, Jody would not want anything bad to happen to Cole and his car. And I feel like it doesn't make sense, as much as she probably wants to be in the trunk so she doesn't get seen and get caught. I think it's more important to her. I think she would rather get caught than to, God forbid, something happens to the car and to Cole. So in real life situations, this is what I'm picking for her. She's gonna be in the front and she's probably gonna be seen very well and caught, but you know what? That's what I'm choosing. I know that she can be... There probably is a better outcome if she's in the trunk, but we're gonna be up front. And take...
Let's go, Aiden.
Take some responsibility.
Try not to attract attention, okay?
For all I know, Aiden is a perfectly good driver, for all I know, but...
Jody?
Thank you. Oh boy.
Oh, what happened?
Jesus Christ, man, what the hell was that all about?
We're so toast.
I think I know exactly what that was all about.
Yeah. Whoops. Whoops.
I told you not to go, and you disobeyed me. You know how dangerous that was for Cole and for you? Hell, Jody, don't you remember Kirsten's birthday party?
Yes, how'd
you? You know what can happen with Aiden, right? Right?
Yes. That's why she struggled with it. That's why she didn't just floor it with Aiden, because she felt guilty. She felt very guilty.
Sorry. Just wanted to go out and be like everyone else for once.
Yeah.
I know, Jody. I know.
I know. Okay, guys, I feel like I need to apologize to many of you guys out there because I feel like due to my actions, that specific chapter ended very shortly, like it was very short. I have a feeling that it would have played out a lot longer and, you know, probably would have shown a scene where she was actually out and about and having fun and doing whatever it was that she was intending and doing, you know, her whole purpose of leaving the lab. I get that. I figured that there was probably a good chunk of content that I just missed. But I couldn't do it. I couldn't go through with it. Like, I was so conflicted. It's really hard because when I play games for the very first time, this is the issue. When I play games for the very first time, it's by default, I want to choose decisions based on what I would choose. It's easier for me to be in character when it's my second playthrough, when it's like my second or third playthrough. I can be more in character with someone who behaves differently from how I would behave in real life because, I don't know, I want to experience a game when I play it for the very first time the way I would experience it in real life if I were the one in control of the situation or in control of the story. And the best way for me to do that without being influenced by any outside information is to take the opportunity to do that blind. I could just, you know, instead, play a game for the first time, playing towards a specific character and not what I would choose. But I don't get as much enjoyment out of that because, you know, eventually I want to, at some point, to play a game like this the way I would play it in real life. And I lose that opportunity when I play it after I already know what's happening. You know, because that's going to affect my decisions. So that's why I did what I did, and that's why I make some of the choices that I make, is because me as a gamer, I want to not let outside influences, prior knowledge to a previous playthrough, to affect my, this is what I would do if it were up to me, kind of play. And I just want to apologize to people for that, but at the same time, this is how I enjoy playing the game. Even though I missed a lot of stuff, that doesn't mean I'm going to miss it forever, because I'm going to be either playing this game again, I'm sure, or watching somebody else LP it. You know, if that means that I'll have to miss some content, I personally don't mind at all. I don't mind it at all. Because I'm going to see the content eventually anyway. Obviously, it'd be nice for you guys to see my reaction to it. I understand that. But, you know, I have to play the game the way I want to play the game. Ultimately. But I think it also makes sense in character too, to be quite honest. Because Jody, like I said, she didn't choose revenge. So I already defined her character as to be the kind of character who was not willing to go the revenge route in at the party. And therefore, part of her, even though she, you know, had a little bit of a rebellious side going on, a rebellious stage going on, part of her just couldn't go through with it. Like, she did not want to hurt anyone. She did not want to put anyone, especially Cole, in danger. And, you know, I'd like to believe that that was the reason why she didn't end up putting herself in the trunk and why she didn't have Aiden floor it and bust through the gate. Because I feel like she would have gotten... She knows she would be in even deeper trouble. Even deeper trouble if she did that. Yes, she would have probably had an awesome night that night. But would it have been worth it? Maybe. Maybe it would have been worth it. Maybe she regrets not gunning it and just going off into the night and just having her, you know, having whatever fun she wants to have. But I don't know. She hesitated because I feel like she just couldn't go through with it because she knew it was wrong. I felt like she knew it was wrong. And yeah, that's the decision that I had her make, and I'm sticking to it, you know? And again, I apologize if you feel that I'm playing the game incorrectly. I think the only way that I would be able... I mean, to be honest, the only way I think I would be playing the game incorrectly is if I was not having fun. And I'm having fun. I'm genuinely having fun. I would not have fun playing the game in a way that I didn't want to, you know? And if the game gives us the option to not do something or to not behave a certain way, they gave us that option for a reason. You know, there are reasons why, because otherwise they would just not give us control over that at all whatsoever, you know? You know, and yeah, that's basically what I have to say about that. I am playing the game the way I want to play the game, and it's how I have fun. This is how I have fun playing the game. And I don't think that, yeah, it would be really cool if I got to see everything, but I don't think that it's going to be beneficial to my viewers either if I'm doing something that I don't think, if I'm doing something that I don't think that I wouldn't enjoy. If I took an action just for the sake of doing whatever it is a lot of you might want me to do, if it compromised, if it went against the way my playstyle works, if that makes sense. So anyway, that's enough of that. We're going to go to the next chapter in the next video. Thank you guys so much for watching this episode of Let's Play Beyond Two Souls. Tune in next time, folks, and until then, love yourselves and love each other.